In 2017, the Federal Communication Commission and head chairman, Ajit Pai, fought to repeal the principle of net neutrality. For those of you who don't know what net neutrality is, I'm going to start off by asking a simple question. How many of you have driven on a highway? Think of the highway as your access to the information giant we call the internet. Net neutrality allows fairness for all competitors and internet users to gain equal access and quality at no cost. The FCC, however, wants to allow even faster and better quality service by charging sites such as Netflix and Instagram and slowing down less popular databases. Think of it as if you're on the highway and you had the opportunity to pay money to use a fast lane, while people who couldn't afford to use the fast lane would have to stay in a slow lane. Three inherent issues I will be discussing in terms to net neutrality are access, freedom, and innovation. The first issue I will be discussing is access. The repealing of net neutrality would allow quicker and better access to some of your favorite streaming sites like Hulu and YouTube. You would have better overall video quality, so you wouldn't have to deal with buffering, fuzziness, or freezing videos, and it would only cost you a small fee. You would no longer have to hassle with loading screens or boring ads interrupting your videos. On the other hand, this would give the FCC the right to shut down sites completely. Companies who don't want to pay an extra fee to keep up with the larger companies could have their websites censored completely to where the public would no longer be able to access them. Which leads me to my second inherent issue, freedom. The United States is all about freedom, right? Well, the FCC believes that too much freedom with the internet can be a bad thing. The repealing of net neutrality would allow the FCC to watch internet users' activity more closely. After researching on www.fcc.gov, I was able to find a statement that reads, "Internet service providers must publicly disclose information regarding their network management. This will discourage harmful practices." With the FCC being able to watch more closely, they would be able to stop potential threats from people such as terrorists, school shooters, and many more. On the other hand, people of the general public and human rights leaders believe that the FCC will abuse this power. They fear that the FCC will take buyouts from large companies in order to shut down smaller companies who are in fear of competition. So for example, say YouTube paid Ajit Pai a bunch of money to shut down a smaller company such as Vimeo. The FCC would be able to thrive off of this market at a cost of smaller companies being shut down. The public believes that this is a big money scheme by the FCC, and it violates their freedom. The third inherent issue I'll be talking about is innovation. In 2017, Pai made a public speech in which he states, "Domestic investment by the nation's 12 biggest internet service providers fell by 5.6%, or $3.6 billion between the start of 2014 and 2015. Ajit and his colleagues believe that by the FCC being able to take more control over the internet, they will resolve this cost difference. Ajit believes that the more investments from these large companies would improve cash flow and therefore increase innovation. Some cons to this, however, is that consumers fear that the public will be unwilling to pay the small fees that they press upon them, and therefore smaller companies trying to start up a business won't be able to because they won't have the money to do so. So whether it's freedom, access, or innovation, these are the issues that will keep the debate of net neutrality going. On May 16, 2018, Democratic voters won as a vote of 52-47 to keep net neutrality in action, but the FCC won't stop. And I can almost guarantee you that this will be reminded at the midterm election. And I hope I was able to give you more insight on this serious topic. Thank you.
I'll stay up there for questions. like YouTube videos won't have any buffering or anything for a small fee. Is it every time you get on YouTube you have to pay a small fee, or is it like
it would be like a membership type of thing, I would assume, kind of like Netflix.
How much would it cost?
I personally, that would just depend on like the FCC and their regulations, but there's no like set amount.
About how long has net neutrality been around?
From what I saw, net neutrality's been around since, I believe it was 2012, but it was resolved in 2015.
If net neutrality did get repealed, would companies have any like say in what happens to them?
When it comes to like their websites and stuff, not really, because it's all contractual. So like, if Netflix, since it is like an internet site, and it was ran through, which I believe they're ran through Comcast, which is their internet service provider. So if the FCC decided to repeal it, they wouldn't have, like Comcast would have to force Netflix to pay more money, and therefore the FCC would be forcing Comcast to pay more money.
So if that net neutrality happened, do you pay like your phone bill for like Verizon, and then you pay them for the apps, you get the
I think the way it would go, like your phone bill wouldn't like change, it would just be like they would all be like separate fees that you would have to pay. So it'd be like you'd pay your regular phone bill, but like if you had a Netflix, because like we're already paying for Netflix, but if they repeal net neutrality, it could go from $9.99 a month to like $15.99 a month. So like it's like the stuff you already pay for, you'll just have to pay more.
All right, thank you.